Good morning, children. In Slave Dynasty, which is already started, you have read about Qutbuddin Aibak, how the Slave Dynasty was started. Aibak died from the horse. He was a very good administrator, but his biggest mistake was he trusted his nobles. So when Iltutmish, who was also a slave of Qutbuddin Aibak, later on he became his son-in-law also, he sat on the throne. Nobles were not satisfied, but he gave them a huge piece of land and pacified them. He also saved his kingdom by denying shelter to Shah of Iran. What does it mean? Mongol leader Genghis Khan. He was ruling such a large part. You can see this yellow portion. That is Mongol Empire. Whole part was ruled by Genghis Khan. But even then, he wanted to conquer more places. He wanted to defeat Shah of Iran. So he asked shelter from Iltutmish. Iltutmish had an idea that if I will help Shah of Iran, it may be possible that Genghis Khan attack on India. So he denied. And in this way, tactfully, he saved India from Mongols' attack in 1222. He extended patronage to art and literature and also completed a very famous monument, Qutub Minar. Now this I have already shown you, achievements of Iltutmish. So many changes were made. First of all, Turkani Chalgani, an organization of ruling nobility. Why? Because Qutbuddin Aibak gave so many facilities, powers to the nobles, which they misused. So now he wanted to keep a check on them. He divided the land into small parts which were known as iktas, and the holders, the people, those who used it, they were known as iktadars. Silver coin was known as tanka, and the metal coin was known as jital, which was introduced by him. He died in 1236. Now see, he had two sons, Rukunuddin and Nasiruddin, but both were incapable. He nominated his daughter Razia. Nobles did not agree. So Rukunuddin Firoz Shah sat on the throne, but in 3 months he was proved incapable. Razia Sultan then became the first female ruler, but he was accused by showing undue favor to Yakut Khan. And the nobles revolted under Altunia, the governor of Bengal. Razia married to Altunia tactfully and recovered the throne of Delhi. But unfortunately, both were killed in 1240. Now from here, a very important role was played by Balban, because no one was there to rule properly, because Nasiruddin, the younger son of Iltutmish, was minor. So Balban only ruled when he became little major, or you can say 1246. He made him the ruler, and himself he became the prime minister and ruled. To check over the nobilities, he started a very strict policy, blood and iron policy. He broke the power of Chahalgani and became very powerful, because earlier they were powerful, now Balban became powerful. Reorganized army and administration, suppressed the Mevatis. To keep check on nobles, he started spy system also. He beheaded the Tughril Khan, governor of Bengal. Restored law and order, also started Sijda system. He died in 1286, but his successors, they were not very good to retain slave dynasty. The last ruler was Kekubad, his grandson, who was killed by Jalaluddin, and he started Khilji dynasty. So, dear children, this chapter is over. Thank you.